Mark Zuckerberg's agreed to meet members of the European Parliament. He could be heading to Brussels as soon as next week, where lawmakers want to question him about Facebook's personal use of data. Samuel Burke is with us.
Richard,
he'd resisted going.
He resisted going, just like he resisted going to the US Congress, but he ended up there. But you actually got us thinking about this. This is unprecedented. We see Facebook execs, all types of execs grilled in front of the US Congress. But think about it. When you think about Rupert Murdoch in front of the UK folks, you don't think of big execs in front of the European Parliament, making it that much tougher for Mark Zuckerberg to prepare for a moment like this, because there's been no moment like this before him.
Right. But if he is going to refuse to go to national parliaments, because you'd never end up, you know, you'd spend your entire life going to them all. In the case of Europe, he can go to one parliament and, pardon the phrase, kill all the birds with one stone.
It's a one-stop shop, but there's every reason to think that this is going to be that much tougher than before. Remember,
why?
The U.S. senators were criticized for being too weak in their questioning. The House came the next day, they were tougher, and the Europeans have had a chance to watch the Americans, and they'll be even tougher. And as you and I both know, having lived on both sides of the pond, Europeans take privacy more seriously. If we just look at this list that I have of all the tough privacy laws that the European Union has enacted, starting with the cookies law, that annoying pop-up that you get in the EU telling you your information can be used or taken, the right to be forgotten. Richard, that took Google by surprise. They didn't think that was going to be, that was going to pass and caused a big problem for them. And then GDPR, General Data Protection, that goes into effect next week. This is the preeminent privacy law of our time, made right here in the European Union.
Okay. And indeed, of course, I'm now inundated, as I'm sure you are, with emails from everybody who's I'm on an email list with, asking for permission to continue sending me emails. Surely all these, like GDPR, the true test will be the enforcement mechanism after it comes in. Because if you're an obscure website in the middle of nowhere and somewhere else in the world, are you going to be worried about GDPR?
Lots of people. You and I were actually just at a conference in the Middle East, and I heard from so many business leaders that they're very concerned about having to comply with this, even though they're in the Middle East, because they, of course, have operations
here in the EU. But that only depends if the EU has a strong enforcement mechanism.
And lots of companies think they will, including Facebook. And there are a lot of people out there who believe very strongly that Google and Facebook will be stronger after this, because they'll be the only ones who can comply fully with this, because they're investing so much money in it to comply because they feel that they have to.
Back to Zuckerberg before. He could wow them and woo them. He could tickle them under the chin. He's a very effective and very impressive man.
There was immense bleeding of the Facebook stock when Mark Zuckerberg went to testify during the heart of the Cambridge Analytica scandal. As he testified,
and where's that stock now?
As he testified, the stock went up. It has done a lot of recovery. Certainly, Facebook would love to see that again when he testifies, possibly next week in Brussels. If it's next week, I'll be there in Brussels for Quest Means Business.
We're looking forward to it. Just make sure you travel economy.
And I'll bring a bell.
No, you won't. Get back. You're not qualified to operate this highly technical piece of equipment. Profitable moment after the break.